My grandfather's clock was too large for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, and it weighed not a penny's weight more. It was bought on the morn that my grandpa was born, and 'twas always his treasure and pride. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. 90 years without slumbering, his life seconds numbering. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. At watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many hours he had spent as a boy. As he grew into manhood, the clock seemed to know, for it shared every sorrow and joy. And it struck 24 as he entered the door with his beautiful and blushing bride. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. My grandfather said that of those he could hire, not a servant so faithful he'd found. For it wasted no time and had but one desire, at the close of each week to be wound. Yes, it kept in its place with not a frown upon its face, and its hands never hung by its side. But it stopped short, never to go again, when the old man died. Then it rang an alarm in the dead of the night, an alarm that for years had been dumb. And we knew that his spirit was pluming for flight, that his hour for departure had come. Yes, the clock kept the time with a soft and muffled chime as we stood there and watched by his side. But it stopped short, and never to go again, when the old man died.